match was exciting. The guys played well, playing their hearts out. But Impala played better, and the better team took the day. Yeah. But generally, both teams played very well.
Yeah. And any boxing that you guys might want to take going into next season?
I think when you get a chance to blow a team off, we need to do it in the past 40 minutes, because we gave Impala an easy lead, 3 tries. But then catching up was a little bit of a problem. So coming in next season or the next time we play, we take all our chances, come all guns blazing.
And your team is still rebuilding because part of your team has your former teammates left, and you're still getting in new players into your system. What do you think you need to do so that next time you will become in the final, you become one of the teams in the final?
I think the new boys just need more exposure, the experience is coming in. Currently they're playing well, but if they keep on playing, the game will go up, will improve, and then they hopefully we'll get our system going and break into the finals.
And just outside Impala in Queens, you've been also part of the Kenya 7 setup. Maybe you could just tell guys how your experience has been on the international level. How has it been for you as a player playing at that level?
It was a wonderful experience. I got the chance to play against more experienced players. More household names, guys you've been seeing watching. The experience was awesome, the exposure too. And bringing the experience back to the young boys who are coming into the setup is a boost for Harley Queens as a team, and for as myself, I'm also growing. Yeah. So it's a wonderful experience playing in the 7th team.
And maybe you guys may not know your journey, but maybe you can just tell guys from when you started picking up the oval ball to right now you're doing. Just tell us that story, how the experience and your journey been.
The journey has been quite interesting, considering I'm from a country, Rugby. The game is not played so much there, so it's kind of a kind of a struggle getting into the game, getting the experience, the exposure. But then, luckily, I got into Nairobi, came to Strathmore, from Strathmore to Queens. From Queens, I joined the national team. I played there for a while, and that's it. So it's been from Webuye, Strathmore, Harley Queens, Kenya Sevens, and hopefully. Who knows what's coming ahead.
And for guys who are looking up to you, and maybe they also playing in those nationwide teams, the local rugby clubs, what can you tell them? What does it take for them to reach your level? Or what should they do to reach your level?
Keep working hard, keep knocking the door, keep pushing yourself, keep giving your 100 all the time. Don't be discouraged, don't listen to people who try to bring you down. Just keep pushing, and the doors will open. Hard work is always rewarded, so keep putting the hard work, keep putting your head where not everybody will be comfortable putting theirs. And things will open, and you'll grow as a player. You'll grow, hopefully, you may play for the national team someday.
And for other guys who are also looking at you, outside of rugby, is there anything that you do apart from just rugby?
Should I say I'm a lawyer or I'm a law student? Should I say? I'm a law student. Taking law in Nairobi University, and I'm also a part-time dancer.
And for the ladies,
when I grow up, I want to be a dancer.
You want to be a dancer?
Yeah.
For the ladies who are also watching you, what should they? Is the Frank in the market?
No, unfortunately.
Unfortunately,
no, he's not in the market. But there are many of my teammates here, and some guys who are very single are still in the market, so they still hope.
Yeah. And how can guys follow you on social media, your social channel?
On Instagram, it's Frank Wanyama, lowercase, all the letters. Twitter, at Wanyama_Frank, and Facebook is also Frank Wanyama.
Yeah. Cheers and thanks for talking.
All right. Thank you. It was a pleasure. Yeah.